Hi folks, welcome to another video from the Malton Motor Company. As you can see today, we're in our workshop with a Jaguar X150, which is an XK convertible. It's an aluminium bodied car. We are prepping this car for sale. We've had the wheels renovated, we've fully engine serviced the car, and if you've seen one of our previous videos, you'll have seen us rebuild all the suspension. Today, before we start machine polishing the outside or doing the inside and getting it exactly how we want it, we're going to have a go at the soft top roof. Now, we've done loads of these before on MGs, on Jaguars, and obviously this isn't a step-by-step guide. This is the way we do it. Now, we've been doing them a long time, so the method that we're going to follow today, the usual method, is mask all the car up best you can. It's not like painting a car, so you don't have to be absolutely precise, but you know, this stuff is really thin. Is the soft top renovator, the black dye is really thin, the waterproofing agent afterwards is really thin, and it does run all over, and you have to get plenty on because it soaks it up, and obviously it's a fairly big roof on one of these. So we're going to use quite a bit of dye to start with. We're going to put two coats of dye on. We've cleaned the roof to an inch of its life. Now, very briefly, how we cleaned it, we used a scrubbing brush, but before we used the scrubbing brush, we sprayed Autoglym interior cleaner on it. Now, there's lots of different chemicals that you can buy to clean soft top roofs, but we've always used Autoglym interior cleaner. And the reason for that is it's quite gentle on the fabric, but it's got some really good cleaning properties within it. And obviously, if you can clean leather seats with it, and clean carpets with it, and material seats in cars with it, then it's obviously, you know, not going to damage your roof because it's designed to clean those materials. And the roof itself, we sprayed the interior cleaner on it, left it only for a few minutes, got a little bit of water on your scrubbing brush, and obviously scrubbed each section at a time, like a quarter of the roof, you know, at a time. Put a bit more water on, just warm water, clean warm water, just so you know you can spread the interior cleaner around, and it sort of lubricates the scrubbing brush a bit, so you can actually, you know, scrub the fabric efficiently. Then of course we left it in the workshop overnight, and we dried it off. Left it in the workshop overnight. It's bone dry now, and it's ready to be dyed. Now, you might think, well, that doesn't really need dyeing. Well, once they've been dyed, they do look so much better. And this car is going to live outside, so the roof needs dyeing, because there's no point in putting waterproofer on top of that finish, the original finish on the roof, because obviously it just wouldn't look right. So you need to re-dye it, and then we can put the waterproofing agent on, and it'll be good to go then. We're going to put the dye on today. I'm not going to show you step by step because I'm holding the camera and I need both hands. So as you can see, this is the roof dry, clean, and ready for dyeing. It's all been masked up. This sheeting isn't just some decorating sheeting that you can buy from any DIY shop for £1. I think it is £1.25 for a sheet. Masking tape there. I've masked the back window up rather than putting paper on it because it's just as easy. Because by the time you finish going round, you know, the edges with the masking tape, you've only got a bit in the middle to go, really. So it's just easier. But yeah, this stuff does wipe off after, you know, in a fashion. But again, you're just making extra work for yourself. And of course, you know, the more you rub the paintwork with this type of stuff and the glass and stuff like that, it's just taking time. It's a waste of time. So it's very quick and easy to put this masking tape around. It took me 15 minutes to mask this car up. Well, it took me more than 15 minutes to get all the dye off the back window and all around the chrome strip round underneath the rim of the roof there, and all over the paintwork and the side windows and the windscreen, and you know, splash marks all over the bodywork and things like that. It'd just be a nightmare. So just get it masked up like this, and then you're ready to go. you try and mask it up best you can around all the rubbers around the hood, because you don't really want the dye and the waterproofing agent all over the rubbers. So yeah, other than that, it's very straightforward. These are the I think most people have seen these over the years. They've been doing it for a long time, haven't they? This brand of dye and waterproof agent, just using a soft Harris brush. So if you use a hard brush, it's more likely to thick, you know, flick everywhere. And we don't want it, I don't want it all over my face. So this is, you know, you just, and we've got a little roller pot, because obviously we can put plenty of dye or waterproofer in there, and then we can, you know, take the residue off there, and then, and we're just doing nice, it doesn't really matter how you brush it on, to be honest, as long as you get plenty on and it's even. On a big roof like this, you will want one of those containers. I'm not saying you'll use it all, but you'll use a fair bit. You'll use less of the waterproofing agent, but you'll use quite a bit of the black renovator. Now, if you still don't have the confidence after watching this video to do your own roof on a, I don't know, MGF, MGB, Jaguar XK, XKA, XJS, whatever you've got, I think you can get this colour. You can get, in this brand, you can get black, green, red. I'm not sure if you can get tan, possibly. So if you don't have the confidence to do it yourself, by all means, we do this for other people. We do this on our sales cars, and we know what we're doing. We've been doing it a long time, and we're always really pleased with the result. It's very straightforward. But if you want us to do it, we can always give you a quote. Give us a call on 07759 938 395. We do offer services like this. We're really busy as a garage doing our own cars and trying to get them ready for sale, but we can offer these sort of services that we can get in and out within a day or so. Obviously, we do the interior headliners on all the full Jaguar range. We do the soft top roofs on generally most soft top cars. We can get wheels refurbished and powder coated. We can also, on Jaguars, mainly Jaguars, because that's what we specialise in, we can do all the leather seat renovation and reconalisation as well for customers. So there's a few little bits and pieces. We do obviously all the jobs on the car, the mechanical, everything ourselves, the cosmetic. But you know, there's only so much we can offer customers because obviously of the time it takes to get these jobs done and how long they're in the workshop for. Obviously it you know, determines whether we can help customers or not, but generally speaking, if you can get it in and out within a day or so, the job, then we can help you. So by all means, give us a call and we can get you a quote. We also do, as you've probably seen on some of our other videos, we do either a three or a five stage machine polish, paintwork renovation, and we also do ceramic coatings as well. So please use that number, 07759 938 395, to give us a call and get a quote for these little jobs that you might want doing on your car to spruce it up, ready for the spring and summer this year. So, right, without further ado, we're going to get on and put some of this dye on, and then we'll be back shortly to show you what it looks like once we've put the dye on. And then we'll do another little clip to show you it with the waterproofing agent on. And then, of course, we'll show you the car when it's all demasked, and we perhaps do another video of us machine polishing this car, because that'll be the next job to do on it. All right, thanks for watching, and we'll get another clip along really soon. Right, guys, as you can see, hopefully, from this video, we've now dyed the roof. In our previous video, we showed you the product that we used to dye it with, and also to waterproof it. So this roof now is holding as much dye or renovator, black renovator, as possible. We're going to leave it overnight now for it to dry, and tomorrow it will be dry. It dries really well. You don't need any heat or anything like that. It just dries, soaks in and dries. But we've saturated the fabric as much as we can. It won't hold any more dye. So therefore, we're just going to leave it. And then tomorrow, we will put the first couple of coats of waterproofing agent on it, which is made by the same company. So as you can see there, we brushed it on. We brushed it on in one direction, first coat, and then we brushed the renovator on in a different direction for the second coat. And we made sure we've gone right around the edges where the windows are and stuff like that, because, you know, they're the bits sometimes people miss, and the rest of the roof looks nice, and then they look sort of grey or drab. You need to make sure you get the dye onto everything, because you want everything to look uniform. Now, there is a few splatters and splashes, but that's why you mask it up. It's simple as that. It is very, 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 very thin stuff, and it goes everywhere. Even if you're really, really careful, it goes everywhere. So, quite pleased with that. That little drip there will come off, just drop on the floor. It's not going to go on the car, so I'm not worried about that. But yeah, there you go. That's why you mask it up like that. But also, that will look fantastic with the waterproofer on, and it'll look fantastic in the morning when it's all dried, uniform black. And then when the rest of the car's machine polished and everything, all tyres dressed and interior done, glass done, you know, everything's detailed, it will look $1 million, that car. So we'll see you tomorrow when we put the renovator, when we put the waterproofing agent on, and then I'll show you what that looks like. Same process, using the same brush. We've washed the brush out. We've washed the container out now, which we were using to tip the black dye in. We've washed all that through now with warm water. It comes out really and cleans really easily when it's obviously still wet. And we'll put the waterproofing agent in there tomorrow and brush that on. And you'll be able to see the difference. Right, we'll catch you tomorrow. Right, here we go, folks. The waterproofer has now been applied, well, two coats of it, and that's as much as it's going to be able to hold that material now. I don't think we'll need to put any more on, if I'm honest. I think that's about it. We give that a good even coating. But we won't know for definite until we've come in tomorrow and had a look. We'll leave it overnight. Just wanted to show you this. This is the waterproof agent that I told you about. But this is what it's like. Look, it's absolutely like just like cloudy water. Yeah, as you can see, it's not. It's got very, very thin consistency, so it's quite difficult to apply without getting it everywhere. But I think we've done all right there, really. I think we've done okay. So what we're going to do is have a quick wipe round before we finish today, and then we'll leave it overnight and see how we get on tomorrow.